decision from the Supreme Court today makes it easier for religious schools to access public funds. The court examined a case involving state tax credits in Montana. The high court ruled the program can stay in place so parents can exercise religious freedom when deciding where to send their children to school. Correspondent Mark Irons reports now outside of the Supreme Court. Mark?
Tracy, a big win for religious freedom today. Chief Justice John Roberts sided with the court's four conservative justices in a decision that effectively strikes down a Montana amendment that barred public funds from going to private schools. Now, some of the justices say that this amendment was created with clear anti-Catholic bigotry.
Writing the court's majority opinion today, Chief Justice John Roberts said a state need not subsidize private education. But once a state decides to do so, it cannot disqualify some private schools solely because they are religious. In 2015, the Montana State Legislature created a tax credit program allowing contributions to be made to certain scholarships for private education. The scholarships could be used at both secular and religious schools, but almost all the recipients attend religious schools. After previous legal challenges, today the High Court upheld the program.
So it's a huge win for religious schools of all kinds.
Helen Alvarez, a law professor at George Mason University, says it looks as though this ruling will help strike down the Blaine Amendment. Present in more than 30 states' constitutions, it has kept public funds from private schools.
And no state law and no state constitution can trump the federal constitution.
Today, in conservative Justice Samuel Alito's opinion, he said the Blaine Amendment showed evidence of anti-Catholic bigotry. At previous oral arguments, Catholic Justice Brett Kavanaugh said grotesque religious bigotry against Catholics was underlying the amendment. The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops is applauding today's ruling.
So it is a tremendous win for us to see the Supreme Court, after so many years, come out and say that these Blaine amendments, which were born at a time of tremendous anti-Catholic bigotry, are in fact unconstitutional.
The Montana Federation of Public Employees says this ruling violates Montana's commitment to public education, our children, and Constitution. Now, Tracy, we could see some other big rulings from the High Court this week. Another case focused on Catholic schools and religious schools' ability to hire and fire employees, and that case that we've been following for years now involving the Little Sisters of the Poor. Tracy.
Okay, thank you so much, Mark. Correspondent Mark Irons reporting for us tonight.